Hi guys, this is Sam Daniel with the Music Tribe Academy, and today we're going to talk about the aux ins and outs on a Behringer X32. So let's get started. So what are the aux ins and outs on an X32? So if you look at the back of an X32, you will see a section of quarter inch and RCA inputs and outputs. This will be the aux section for the X32. The aux ins and the aux outs are completely independent of each other. The aux ins on the X32 will be controlled by the aux faders on the X32. These faders can be accessed by pressing the aux in USB effects returns button on the left-hand side of the console. This will show you the green labeled aux faders that will then control the level of signals that are going into the quarter inch and RCA aux ins. So how do we determine what signal will be present on the aux in faders? To see this, you will look at the input routing for the X32, which is handled by pressing the routing button and then staying in the home tab on the screen. The far right-hand column will say aux in remap. This is how you determine what six signals will be present for the six aux faders on the console. By default, they are set to aux ins, which is just referring to the quarter inch and RCA aux ins. However, you can see from the column that you have different selections for different signals that could be present on the six aux faders. So a couple possible uses for the aux ins on the back of the X32 would be to connect up the audio output of your smartphone to go into the mixer, or you could also connect up the output of a synthesizer or keyboard to go into the console. So now that we've talked about the aux ins on the X32, let's talk about the aux outs. The aux outs are just another series of line level outputs that can be routed for anything that you need. To see this, all you will do is press the routing button on the board and then page over to the aux out tab. In this tab, you can then select in the left column the aux out you want to work with. And then in the fourth column from the left, you can choose the output signal to be present on that aux out. You can select the main left, the main right, any of the mix buses, matrices, or direct outs. Just remember that whatever selection you choose, you need to press down the encoder to lock in that choice. So using these quarter inch and RCA outputs can be handy for a couple scenarios. One particular scenario would be if you happen to run out of the XLR outputs on the back of the console and you still need to use some other outputs for output signal. Well, these aux outs would come in handy for that. A couple other scenarios would involve broadcast. If you need to send a simple line level signal out to a broadcast computer, say in a church scenario, or if you have a separate recording device that you'd like to use to track signal, you can do that with the aux outs on the console. Okay guys, that's it. I hope you found this helpful. And if you have any comments or suggestions on future topics, then please comment below and let us know. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.